Hello everyone, welcome to ENT student. My topic is about the differential diagnosis of furunculosis and acute mastoiditis. Now first we'll learn few points about the furunculosis and acute mastoiditis. Furunculosis is also called as localized acute otitis externa, and it is an staphylococcal infection of an hair follicle. It can be single or even the multiple, and it is confined only to the cartilaginous part of a meatus. Now coming to an acute mastoiditis, it is an inflammation of a mucosal lining of both the antrum and the mastoid air cell system. Now coming to the topic, and how can this both can be differentiated? Furunculosis is differentiated from an acute mastoiditis by the following few points. First one is discharge can never be mucoid or mucopurulent, because mucoid element is only discharge. It is secreted only from the middle ear, not from an external ear, because external ear doesn't have any mucoid secreting glands. And powerful movements of a pinna, it can be seen, it can be elicited by the whenever we are putting in pressure over the tragus or in cartilaginous part of a meatus, that it causes a severe pain. And even whenever we are chewing our food also, due to the jaw movements, there is a pain to a pinna. And next, enlargement of preauricular or postauricular lymph nodes, and even the tenderness of a lymph nodes is seen. And conducting hearing loss is usually the mild, because there is an occlusion of a meatus. Swelling is also seen. It is confined only to the cartilaginous part, and absence of preceding acute otitis media, and absolutely the normal looking tympanic membrane. Now coming to the last point, X-ray of mastoid with clear hair cell system exclude the acute mastoiditis. Now here are the few pictures of furunculosis and acute mastoiditis. This is a picture of furunculosis of a hair cell, and this is acute mastoiditis. Here we can see the postauricular mastoid swelling. This